أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. Today we shall be beginning with the beginning of the fifth section of Surah Bani Israel. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ولقد صرفنا في هذا القرآن ليذكروا وما يزيدهم إلا نفورا. صدق الله العظيم. And we have explained our ayat in the Quran in various ways, in various styles, in various sequences, so that they get admonition, but they are not getting anything else but aversion. They are running away. قُلْ لَوْ كَانَ مَعَهُ آلِهَةٌ كَمَا يَقُولُونَ. Say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if there had been other gods along with God, Allah, كَمَا يَقُولُونَ, as they say, إِذَا لَبْتَغَوْا إِلَىٰ ذِي الْعَرْشِ سَبِيلًا, then they would have tried to find some way to the highest throne. You know, if there is a king, and under the kings there are subordinate chieftains. Now we know it's a rule that some of the chieftain tries to become the king. Why shouldn't he occupy the throne? So had there been other gods alongside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there would have been chaos in the universe. And someone might have rebelled and, you know, stood in revolt against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanahu. Glory is His. Wa ta'ala amma yaqooloon uluwun kabira. And He is much, much exalted, high up than those things which they are saying. Tusabbihu lahu samawatu sab'a. All the seven heavens keep on glorifying Him. Wal ard, as well as the earth. Wa man fihinna, and all those things and beings which are in the heavens and the earth. At every time, always, they are glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa im min shay'in illa yusabbihu bihamdihi. There's nothing in the whole of the universe which is not glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with His praise. وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَصْبِيحَهُمْ. But you cannot understand their glorification. How they are glorifying, how they are praising, you can't understand. إِنَّهُ كَانَ حَلِيمًا غَفُورًا. Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forbearing. He doesn't take hasty decisions. He gives time to people to amend their ways, to mend their ways. And He is forgiving. وَإِذَا قَرَأْتَ الْقُرْآنَ جَعَلْنَا بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ حِجَابًا مَسْتُورًا. And when you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, recite Quran unto them, we put between you and them a hidden curtain, between you and those who don't believe in the hereafter. In this surah we have seen repeatedly, this idea comes up that the main thing, basic thing, is the belief in the hereafter. In the first section also, there was this Quran, إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمُ وَيُبَشِّرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ أَنَّ لَهُمْ أَجْرًا كَبِيرًا وَأَنَّ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ أَعْتَدْنَا لَهُمْ عَذَابًا أَلِيمًا. The most basic thing is to believe in the resurrection and to believe in the life of hereafter. So those who don't believe, when you recite Quran unto them, we put a curtain, invisible, hidden curtain, between you and them. وَجَعَلْنَا عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ أَكِنَّةً. In addition, we put wheels on their hearts, أَن يَفْقَهُوهُ, which prevents them from understanding what you are reciting to them. وَفِي أَذَانِهِمْ وَقْرًا. In addition, in their ears is heaviness. وَإِذَا ذَكَرْتَ رَبَّكَ فِي الْقُرْآنِ وَحْدَهُ. And when you mention your Lord in Quran, that He is alone, without any partners, وَاللَّهُ عَلَىٰ أَدْبَارِهِمْ نُفُورًا. They turn their backs and go away with aversion, with displeasure. نَحْنُ عَالَمُ بِمَا يَسْتَمِعُونَ بِهِ إِذْ يَسْتَمِعُونَ إِلَيْكَ. We very well know what they want to listen from you when they come and sit near you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and apparently they listen to you attentively. وَإِذْ هُمْ نَجْوَىٰ. This they did actually only to impress upon their common people, their masses, that we are sincere, we want to understand what Muhammad has to say. Actually, he has nothing to say. He has no logic in what he is saying. So to impress this upon the common people, so they don't go near Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and don't hear to what he is saying. وَإِذْهُمْ نَجْوَىٰ. And when they are alone, in privacy, is يَقُولُ الظَّالِمُونَ. When these evil doers say to each other, إِن تَتَّبِعُونَ إِلَّا رَجُلَ الْمَسْحُورَىٰ. You are following only a person who is bewitched. Magic has overcome him, overcome Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he is a bewitched person, so don't follow him. Maybe someone, you know, might have said, okay, what Muhammad said today, it appeals to me. So then they would say, oh no, no, what has happened to you? He is a bewitched person. Magic has overcome over him, so don't follow him. انظر كيف ضربوا لك الامثال. See, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what type of similitudes they strike for you. فلا يستطيعون سبيلا. They will not be able to get to the right path. وقالوا اذا كنا عظاما ورفاتا. And they say, when a time will come after our death that will become only bones and fragments. أئنا لمبعوثون خلقا جديدا. Are we going to be raised again in a new creation? This resurrection? How is it possible? Tell them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, kunu hijaratan. You say you will become dust, fragments. You become stones, aw hadidan, aw iron, aw khalqan mimma yakbaru fi sudurikum, or anything which you think is harder than the stone and the steel and iron also. فَسَيَقُولُونَ مَنْ يُعِيدُنَا. Then they will say to you, who will bring us back from our dead bodies, from our graves? قُلِ الَّذِي فَطَرَكُمْ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ. Say, the same who created you for the first time. Allah created you out of nothing, out of dust or clay, or out of, you know, a drop of sperm. He created you. So whosoever could create you from that, can't he again recreate you? So is it just, it is logical that he can do it. قُلِ الَّذِي فَطَرَكُمْ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ فَسَيُنْغِذُونَ إِلَيْكَ رُؤُوسَهُمْ. And then they will shake their heads before you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And finally the question they will put is, وَيَقُولُونَ مَتَاهُ. Okay. Then when will it happen? قُلْ عَسَىٰ أَنْ يَكُونَ قَرِيبًا. Say, maybe that it has come very near. But this knowledge of the time, of the hour, I don't have. It is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When that asa, the promised hour will come, when there will be resurrection, I don't know. What I know is that it will happen. That asa will come. That you will be resurrected. And this is the message that I have to convey to you. يَوْمَ يَدْعُوكُمْ فَتَسْتَجِيبُونَ بِحَمْدِهِ. When your Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will call you, you will respond praising Him, running towards Him. وَتَظُنُّونَ إِن لَبِسْتُمْ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. And you will feel at that time that you didn't live in the world or in the graves, but for a very short time. A very short time passed. Just as we can feel, you know. Now if I am 68, I can remember some, you know, incidents when I was 5 years of age, and it seems it was yesterday. The whole time which has passed appears to be zero. In the same way, they will feel on that day of judgment that they didn't remain in the earth, in this world, or in the graves, but for a very little while. وَقُلِّ عِبَادِي يَقُولُ الَّتِيهِ أَحْسَنُ. Now because in that, you know, country or society, this argument was going on. They say this, you say this, they say this, you say this. This is going on. This dialogue, this argument, it was continuing for 12 years. This surah was revealed in the 11th year after the beginning of Wahy. So it's a long drawn process. And there is conflict. And they wanted to provoke Muslims, say bad names to them, so that they become violent. If they become violent, then we shall crush them. So this provocation they tried. But here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving instructions to the Muslim. Don't be provoked. Take all things patiently. Because if you are provoked, if you react, if you give the reply in the same coin, then you know, Shaitan, he will be happy. Because then you will quarrel with each other and your mission, you know, it will be in loss. وَقُلْ لِعِبَادِي يَقُولُ الَّتِي هِي أَحْسَنُ. O Muhammad, tell my bondsmen, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the believers, they should say only that thing which is very beautiful. No bad words should come from their tongues. Inna shaitana yanzaku bainahum. Shaitan verily intends to sow the seeds of dissension between you and the people to whom you are conveying the message of Allah. Inna shaitana kana lil insani aduwwan mubeena. Surely Satan is for the human beings a clear enemy. Rabbukum alamu bikum. Your Lord knows you best. Each one of you is in His knowledge. In yasha yarhamkum. If He wills, He will have mercy upon you and forgive you. How in yasha yu'azibkum. Or if He wills, He will chastise you. He will punish you. This authority is in His hands. He can forgive anybody. But whomsoever He wants, He will punish. You know, in the last part of Suratul Baqarah, لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَإِنْ تُبْدُوا مَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَوْ تُخْفُوهُ يُحَاسِبْكُمْ بِهِ اللَّهِ فَيَغْفِرُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيُعَذِّبُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. He will forgive whomsoever He would like. But He would bring to the book and chastise and punish whomsoever He will like. رَبُّكُمْ عَلَمُ بِكُمْ. He knows you best. And what you are doing, He knows it. إِنْ يَشَا يَرْحَمْكُمْ. If He wishes, if He wills, He will have mercy on you. أَوْ إِنْ يَشَا يُعَذِّبْكُمْ. Or if He wills and wishes, He will chastise you. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ عَلَيْهِمْ وَكِيلًا. And we have not sent you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a guardian upon them. Your function, your duty is to convey to them, that's all. You are not responsible for them. وَرَبُّكَ عَالَمُ بِمَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. And your Lord knows best who are in the heavens and in the earth. وَلَقَدْ فَضَّلْنَا بَعْضَ النَّبِيِّينَ عَلَىٰ بَعْضٍ. And we have raised in status some of the prophets over the others. We have it, you know, the beginning of the third part of Quran. تِلْكَ الرُّسُلُ فَضَّلْنَا بَعْضَهُمْ عَلَىٰ بَعْضٍ. Among these messengers of Allah, among these prophets, some are at a higher level, some are comparatively at a lower level. But فَضَّلْنَا بَعْضَ النَّبِيِّنَ عَلَىٰ بَعْضٍ. Now this also can become a point of argument. The Jews might say that Moses is afzal. And now you are fighting them. No, Muhammad is afzal. No use. You should talk about the basic things. There's no use engaging in this dialogue, engaging in this. The prophets has said, don't declare me afzal than even Hazrat Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam. Among all the messengers of Allah, he is the only one who committed a mistake, who was punished. He was swallowed by the fish and then, you know, vomited out. You know what happened to him? And he had to apologize to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu minaz zalimeen. He is the only one among the prophets and messengers of Allah. And the prophet said, don't say that I am higher than even Jonah, Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam. But what the Muslims do is absolutely to the contrary. فَضَلْنَا بَعْضَ النَّبِيِّينَ عَلَىٰ بَعْضٍ. We have made some of the prophets higher than the others. وَآتَيْنَا دَاوُودَ زَبُورًا. And we gave David alayhi salatu wasalam, the Psalms, a very beautiful book. Very beautiful book, praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلِدُ الَّذِينَ زَعَمْتُمْ مِنْ دُونِهِ. Now this is directed towards those idolaters and idol worshippers and the mushrikeen. Muhammad said to them, call upon those whom you think are gods beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلَا يَمْلِكُونَ كَشْفَ الضُّرِّ عَنْكُمْ وَلَا تَحْوِيلًا. They have no power or authority to relieve you from any distress or to change your condition. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ. Those whom you are calling upon and you think they are partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, maybe the angels, maybe the saints who had died. But Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ يَبْتَغُونَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهُمُ الْوَسِيلَةِ. In that unseen world of the hereafter or barzakh, they are striving. Whom they are calling, help us out of this difficulty. They are striving to get nearer and nearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they want to become nearer and nearer. وَيَرْجُونَ رَحْمَتَهُ. And they hope to have mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَخَافُونَ عَذَابَهُ. At the same time, they keep fearing His chastisement. إِنَّ عَذَابَ رَبِّكَ كَانَ مَحْسُورًا. Definitely, the chastisement of your Lord is something to be shunned and feared. وَإِن مِّن قَرْيَةٍ لَا نَحْنُ مُهْلِكُوهَا قَبْلَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَوْ مُعَذِّبُوهَا عَذَابٌ شَدِيدًا. And there is no township or city on the surface of the earth which we will not destroy before the day of resurrection, or to which we will not send a very painful chastisement. كَانَ ذَلِكَ فِي الْكِتَابِ مَسْتُورًا. This had already been written in the book of knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا مَنَعْنَا نُرْسِلَ بِالْآيَاتِ إِلَّا أَنْ كَذَّبَ بِهَا الْأَوَّلُونَ. And nothing has prevented us from sending signs, miracles, visible miracles. We have seen, you know, in Suratul An'am, that people were demanding, if you say you are a messenger of Allah like Moses, Moses showed so many miracles, then you also show miracles. We shall find it. This is coming just now. A detailed discussion will come on this subject. But Allah says, وَمَا مَنَعْنَا نُرْسِلَ بِالْآيَاتِ. Nothing has prevented us from sending these miracles, إِلَّا أَنْ كَذَّبَ بِهَا الْأَوَّلُونَ. Except this, that those people also who were befaced, they belied them. They never believed them then. Did Fir'aun and his people accepted Moses on the basis of the miracles? Did the nation of Samud accept the call of Salih alayhi salam when, according to their demand, a pregnant camel, she camel, came out of a rock? But you know, even then, they didn't come to believe in him. So they belied. So we don't want to send now any miracles. وَمَا مَنَعْنَا أَن نُرْسِلَ بِالْآيَاتِ إِلَّا أَن كَذَّبَ بِهَا الْأَوَّلُونَ. وَآتَيْنَا ثَمُودَ النَّاقَةَ مُبْصِرَةً فَظَلَمُوا بِهَا. We gave Samud that she camel to open their eyes. But they did wrong to her. وَمَا نُرْسِلُ الْآيَاتِ إِلَّا تَخْفِيفًا. And we don't send our signs but to warn. وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لَكَ إِنَّ رَبَّكَ أَحَاطَ بِالنَّاسِ. And recall when we said to you that your Lord has encompassed all human beings. وَمَا جَعَلْنَا الرُّؤْيَا الَّتِي أَرَيْنَاكَ إِلَّا فِتْنَةً لِلنَّاسِ. And also we didn't make the vision that we showed you but as a test for the humanity. فِتْنَةً لِلنَّاسِ. وَالشَّجَرَةُ الْمَلْعُونَةَ فِي الْقُرْآنِ. And that tree which is cursed in Quran, Shajarat al-Zaqoom, in Surah Al-Waqi'ah and somewhere else also, there is the mention of a tree which will grow from the bottom of Jahannam. Now they said, how is it possible? You say there is fire in Jahannam, in that hell, and you, at the same time you say a tree will be growing from the bottom. But now they don't know that the rules of that world are different. The physical rules governing this world and this universe are different. And the rules of that world would be different. So all these things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَنُخَوِّفُهُمْ فَمَا يَزِيدُهُمْ إِلَّا تُغْيَانًا كَبِيرًا. We only want to warn them. But it is not giving them anything except arrogance. Their arrogance is increasing and increasing and increasing. وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ. Now note, it is the fourth time that this story of Iblis and Adam is coming in Quran. Here it is very brief. Fourth section of Surah Al-Baqarah, quite detailed. Then the second section of Surah Al-Araf, more detailed even than Surah Al-Baqarah. Then we had it in Surah Al-Hijr. And now for the fourth time. And you will find that again in the next Surah Kahf, again you will find it. Here also it is in the beginning of the seventh section of Surah Bani Israel. In Surah Kahf you will find again the beginning of the seventh section of Surah Kahf. That is this story of Iblis and Adam. And recall when we said to the angels, prostrate before Adam. فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا Iblis. They all prostrated except Iblis. قَالَ أَحْجُدُ لِمَنْ خَلَقْتَ تِينَ. He said, shall I prostrate before that one whom you have created out of mud? I was created out of fire. I am better than him. I am higher than him. How can I prostrate before him? قَالَ أَرَأَيْتَكَ هَذَا الَّذِي كَرَّمْتَ عَلَيَّ. And he said, O Lord, O God, just look. This fellow human being, this Adam, whom you have honored more than me, above me, لَيْنْ أَخَّرْتَنِي لَا يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ. If you can keep me alive till the day of judgment, لَا أَحْتَنِكَنَّ ذُرِّيَّتَهُ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. I shall certainly uproot his progeny, except a few. I will take the whole progeny of Adam astray towards shirk and kufr. I will prove that Adam is not capable of the position that has been given to him by you. قَالَ ذَبْ فَمَنْ تَبِعَكَ مِنْهُمْ فَإِنَّ جَهَنَّمَ جَزَاؤُكُمْ جَزَاءً مَغْفُورًا. Allah said, okay, go away, be gone. Whosoever from them follows you, then for you, all of you, this hell would be the recompense, the reward, and this reward will be befitting for you. For you also, and for all the human beings from the progeny of Adam who follow you. وَاسْتَفْزِزْ مَنِ اسْتَطَعْتَ مِنْهُمْ بِصَوْتِكَ. And instigate whomsoever from amongst them you can with your voice. وَأَجْلِبْ عَلَيْهِمْ بِخَيْلِكَ وَرَجِلِكَ. And rally over them your horsemen as well as their footmen, foot soldiers. وَشَارِكْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَوْلَادِ. And share with them their properties and their children. وَعِدْهُمْ. And make promises to him. وَمَا يَعِدُهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ إِلَّا هُرُورًا. But all the promises that Satan makes with Adam and his progeny is nothing but deceit. إِنَّ عِبَادِي لَيْسَ لَكَ عَلَيْهِمْ سُلْطَانٌ. Allah declared, as for my bondsmen who believe in me, who love me, who worship me, you will have no authority over them. You will not be able to force them to the wrong path. You will have no authority, no power. إِنَّ عِبَادِي لَيْسَ لَكَ عَلَيْهِمْ سُلْطَانٌ وَكَفَى بِرَبِّكَ وَكِيلًا. And your Lord is sufficient as a guardian of all the believers. رَبُّكُمُ الَّذِي يُسْجِي لَكُمُ الْفُلْكَ فِي الْبَحْرِ لِتَبْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِهِ إِنَّهُ كَانَ بِكُمْ رَحِيمًا. Your Lord is He who drives for you the ships of the sea so that you can get, you know, benefits in trading And you get from his fazl, from his bounty. إِنَّهُ كَانَ بِكُمْ رَحِيمًا. And he is very much merciful for you. وَإِذَا مَسَّكُمُ الضُّرُّ فِي الْبَحْرِ. When some harm and affliction comes over you in the sea, when you are at the sea, open sea, and there is a storm, and you think, my might be that your boat or ship sink, then you call whom? Allah. Nobody else. Even all the mushrikeen, they never call upon their false gods, but they call only Allah. ظَلَّ مَنْ تَدْعُونَ إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ. All those deities, false deities, whom you call upon, they are lost to you at that time. You never call upon them except Allah. فَلَمَّا نَجَّاكُمْ إِلَى الْبَرِّ. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saves you from that affliction and brings you to the land, أَعْرَضْتُمْ. Now you turn away your faces. Now you again commit kufr and shirk. وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ كَفُورًا. Verily, insan, human beings, they are very ungrateful to Lord. أَفَأَمِنْتُمْ. Are you secure? أَنْ يَخْسِفَ بِكُمْ جَانِبَ الْبَرِّ. Allah can cause a landslide which can swallow you on the land. After landing on the land, you see you are absolutely secure. Nothing can come to you. If a storm could come at the sea, on the land also, there could be a landslide, and it might swallow you all. أَوْ يُرْسِلَ عَلَيْكُمْ حَاسِبًا. Or he can send over you a stone storm. Hasiba used to be a very strong wind in which small pebbles and stones are coming like bullets. You know, these small pebbles and small stones, which were carried by that strong wind, they worked as bullets. So this is Hasiba. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he can send Hasiba on you. ثُمَّ لَا تَجِدُوا لَكُمْ وَكِيرًا. Then you will not find any guardian for you. أَمْ أَمِنْتُمْ. Do you feel secure? أَنْ يُعِيدَكُمْ فِيهِ تَارَةً أُخْرَى. That Allah might take you again to the sea. فَيُرْسِلَ عَلَيْكُمْ قَاصِفًا مِنَ الرِّيحِ. And then he can send upon you a hurricane of wind. فَيُغْرِقَكُمْ بِمَا كَفَرْتُمْ. And drown you for what you have been doing. ثُمَّ لَا تَجِدُ لَكُمْ عَلَيْنَا بِهِ تَبِيعًا. And then you will not be able to find anybody who can take revenge from your side. وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ وَحَمَلْنَاهُمْ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ. And surely we have honored the children of Adam. That is we people, human beings. وَحَمَلْنَاهُمْ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ. And we carry them on the land also and on the sea also. Well, who is carrying you in the ships? This is the natural laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with which these ships are floating in the sea. How we walk on this land, this is again the laws of the nature according to which we can walk. So it is as if Allah is carrying us. لَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ. We have honored the children of Adam. وَحَمَلْنَاهُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ. And we carry them on the land also and in the sea. وَرَزَقْنَاهُ مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ. And we have provided them with good things, good food. وَفَضَّلْنَاهُمْ عَلَىٰ كَثِيرٍ مِّمَّنْ خَلَقْنَا تَفْضِيلًا. And we have exalted them on most of our creations. This human being, you know, Adam was created as a vicegerent of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All the angels were asked to prostrate before him. So this is the position of Adam and his progeny. We must know our position in this universe. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given us this status. Then, يَوْمَ نَدْعُوا كُلَّ أُنَاسٍ بِإِمَامِهِمْ. Recall the day of judgment, when we shall call every people, every community, with their imam. And imam here has been translated in two forms. Either their leader, maybe the messenger of Allah who was sent to that nation, or some other leader, or also the record of their deeds. This is also a possible translation of this word, the book in which the deeds are recorded. یوم ندعو کل اناس بامامہم فمن اوتی کتابہ بیمینہ. So whosoever will be given his book, his record, his balance sheet in his right hand, فَأُولَٰئِكَ يَقْرَؤُونَ كِتَابَهُمْ, they will be reading happily their balance sheet, their sheet of their deeds. وَلَا يُظْلَمُونَ فَتِيلًا, and they will not be wronged in the least. وَمَنْ كَانَ فِي هَذِهِ أَعْمَى, but whosoever had remained blind in this world, blind not of eyes, blind of heart, he couldn't see the realities. He couldn't understand the wahi of Allah, the revelations which were coming to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Actually, as a human being, he was blind. He was deaf. He was dead, I should say. So whosoever has been like this in this world, فَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ عَامَى وَضَلُّ سَبِيلًا, so in the hereafter, also he will be raised blind and more far away from the straight path. وَإِنْ كَادُوا, now it's a very important issue that is coming now. A very important issue is being discussed now. This has once before come in Surah Yunus. الَّذِينَ قَالُوا, الَّذِينَ لَا يَرْجُونَ لِقَانَا, those people who don't hope to meet us, they demand from you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قِئْتِ بِقُرْآنٍ غَيْرِ هَذَا أَوْ بَدِّلْهُ, change this Qur'an or present some other Qur'an. This is too rigid, very uncompromising. It doesn't accept anything of ours. Well, we can have a compromise, a deal, but you have to give and take. Something you can, you know, present that we accept, and some of our things you have to accept. Not that everything that you say should be accepted by us. So now the same thing is coming here. وَإِنْ كَادُوا لَيَفْتِنُونَكَ عَنِ الَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ لِتَفْتَرِيَ عَلَيْنَا غَيْرَهُ, and they are bent upon misguiding you and tempting you, instigating you away from that which we have revealed to you, so that you should forge something else and then attribute it to us, which is acceptable to them. The revelation that Allah is sending you, they are not acceptable to them. So they want change. From what change? Forge something and say, this has come from Allah, then we shall accept. وَإِذَا لَتَّخَذُوكَ خَلِيلًا, and then they will make you a friend. You know, there's no enmity between you personally and them. The enmity is between Qur'an and them. What Qur'an is saying is not acceptable to them. So actually, now this is pressure on you. And because the conditions were very bad, very bad. 11 years had passed. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did his best to convey the message of Allah. Only about 125 people accepted Islam. And you know, the decision had been taken at the Darul Nadwa, the parliament of Makkah, that now we shall kill Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is why he went to Taif. Maybe that some big chief of Taif, he accepts Islam, and then he supports Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so he can shift his base from Makkah to Taif. But there what happened to him in 2 days wouldn't happen to him in 10 years at Makkah. Stoning. And he was injured. He was bleeding. Names were called to him. And then he had to come back empty-handed. Nobody accepted Islam. And then he could enter Makkah only after taking the refuge of a mushrik kafir. He couldn't enter because the decision had been taken. He will be killed. Unless some of the chief of Makkah gives him the aman, the peace, the refuge, he couldn't enter. So Mut'im bin Adi, who died as a mushrik and kafir, he never embraced Islam. But the Prophet said on the day of Badr, when there were 70 prisoners of Quraysh in the hands of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, had Mut'im bin Adi been alive today, and had he said to me and asked me to let them go without any ransom, I would have let them go. He was so much, you know, under that ihsan that Mut'im bin Adi did to him, that he gave him the aman and gave him the refuge. These are the conditions. So he was very much hard-pressed. And in this condition, people come, okay, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we can have We can have a compromise. We can have a deal. You change your stance and your position a bit so that we can agree. وَإِنْ كَادُوا لَيَفْتِنُونَكَ عَنِ الَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ لَتَفْتَرِيَ عَلَيْنَا غَيْرَهُ, so that you forge something and then you attribute it to us. وَإِذَنْ لَتَّخَذُوكَ خَلِيلًا, and then all enmity will disappear, evaporate, and then they will make you a friend. But وَلَوْلَا أَنْ سَبَّتْنَاكَ, had we not make you stand firm, it is just possible. لَقَدْ كِتَّ تَرْكَنُوا إِلَيْهِمْ شَيْئًا خَلِيلًا, you might have leaned towards them a bit due to that pressure. That is why I depicted the whole picture, you know. What were the circumstances? How hard pressed was Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam at that time? And now this was the offer. So, as a human being, there could be some, you know, an idea. Okay, let us have some compromise. No. But Allah made you strong and firm. وَلَوْلَا أَنْ سَبَّتْنَاكَ, and were it not we, that we had made you stand firm, indeed you would have well nigh inclined to them a little. But now the hardest ayah of Quran, إِذَا اللَّهَ عَزَقْنَاكَ زَيْفَ الْحَيَاةِ وَزَيْفَ الْمَمَاتِ, had this thing happened, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we would have given you double punishment in the day, in this life, during the life, during this world, and double punishment after the death. Who is being addressed? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Who is the last messenger of Allah? The beloved of Allah. Khalilullah, Habibullah. For the last 11 years, day and night he has been working. He has devoted himself wholly and solely for the cause of Allah. But even to him, إِذَا اللَّهَ عَزَقْنَاكَ ضِعْفَ الْحَيَاةِ وَضِعْفَ الْمَمَاتِ, had this thing happened, had you succumbed to the pressures of these disbelievers and forced something and attributed it to us, then we would have given you double the chastisement, double the punishment of the life, this life, hayat, وَضِعْفَ الْمَمَاتِ, and double in the death. ثُمَّ لَا تَجِدُ لَكَ عَلَيْنَا نَصِيرًا, and then you would not find for you anybody who can help you against us. الْعَبْدُ عَبْدٌ وَإِن تَرَقَّى وَالرَّبُّ رَبٌّ وَإِن تَنَزَّلَ, Allah is Allah, He is Lord. Although He might come down to the first heaven, as there is a hadith that every night He comes down. And Muhammad is Abd, bondsman, servant. Although he might have ascended to the seventh heaven, in in Isra, in Miraj, but the difference between the Creator and the created, the Lord and the bondsman, that remains. وَإِنْ كَادُوا لَيَسْتَفِزُّونَكَ مِنَ الْأَرْضِ لِيُخْرِجُوكَ مِنْهَا, and they are bent upon, these kuffar of Makkah are bent upon, to frighten you from this land, so that they turn you away out from this land. وَإِذَا اللَّهِ لِيُخْرِجُوكَ مِنْهَا وَإِذَا اللَّهِ يَلْبَسُونَ خِلَافَكَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. Now here Allah is not denying, because this was going to happen. By the permission of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was to migrate to Medina. So he is not saying that it won't happen. What he is saying? إِذَا اللَّهِ يَلْبَسُونَ خِلَافَكَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. In that case, they will also not be able to live at Makkah for a long time. And this is the fact. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam migrated in the year 612. And 614, in the Battle of Badr, 70 of the chieftains of Quraysh, they were lying dead in the battlefield of Badr. So, and after 6 years, the whole Makkah that was conquered by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Where were the chieftains now? Where was Abu Jahl? Where was Uqba ibn Abi Mu'ayt? Where was Abu Lahab? Where was Walid bin Mughira? Where are they? Gone. Gone with the wind. إِذَا اللَّا يَلْبَسُونَ خِلَافَكَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. If they compel you to leave Makkah and go away from Makkah, they will also not be able to live there for some long time. سُنَّةَ مَنْ قَدَرْ سَلْنَا قَبْلَكَ مِنْ رُسُلِنَا. This has been our rule. our law, our practice with all the messengers of Allah which were sent before you. وَلَا تَجِدُ لِسُنَّتِنَا تَحْوِيلًا. And you will never find any change in the laws and rules and practice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whenever a messenger was compelled to leave the place, then the chastisement came and the whole nation was destroyed. So this will happen to them if it happens. Now there are instructions to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to his companions. In these hard times, what should you do? How can you be steadfast? What will give you the energy and strength to bear all these things? Number one, أَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِدُلُوكِ الشَّمْسِ إِلَىٰ غَسَقِ اللَّيْلِ وَقُرْآنُ الْفَجْرِ إِنَّ قُرْآنَ الْفَجْرِ كَانَ مَشْهُودًا. Keep this prayer established from the time when the sun declines to the darkness of the night. Now this Salatul Zuhr, after the sun, you know, it just starts getting down. And now Zuhr, now Asr, now Maghrib and Isha. Four prayers. لِدُلُوكِ الشَّمْسِ إِلَىٰ غَسَقِ اللَّيْلِ. Till the night becomes fully dark. وَقُرْآنَ الْفَجْرِ. And take to the recitation of Qur'an at dawn, Fajr. Now this Salatul Fajr is not called Salat, recitation of Qur'an. Why? Because in the Salat of Fajr, there is the practice that much of Qur'an must be recited. In the other prayers, you can have a few ayat in one rakat, but in Fajr, sizable portion of Qur'an has to be recited. Qur'an al-Fajr. Recitation of Qur'an at the time of dawn. Inna Qur'an al-Fajr kana mashhuda. Verily, the recitation of Qur'an at the time of dawn, it is witnessed by the angels. So this was instruction number one. Instruction number two, specially for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was the leader. He was the chief. So he had to have more than the common Muslims. He had to persevere more. He had to put in more struggle, more time. وَمِنَ اللَّيْلِ فَتَهَجَّدْ بِهِ نَافِلَةً لَكَ. And from the time of night, you keep awake with this Qur'an, reading this Qur'an. And this is additional worship for you. It is prescribed. This tahajjud for Muhammad was farz, imperatively. It was an additional farz for him. For the whole of the ummah, it is nafl, it is additional. You may pray, you may not pray. If you are not praying, you are not committing any sin. But for Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it was essential. It was imperative. It was ordained. It was commanded to him. نَافِلَةً لَكْ. It is additional for you. أَسَىٰ يَبْعَسَكَ رَبُّكَ مَقَامًا مَحْمُودًا. There is hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your Lord, will give you that station, praiseworthy station, مَقَامًا Mahmud. In the hereafter, what is that station? We can't understand. But there is some station, a special station, مَقَامًا Mahmud, which will be allotted to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Number three, وَقُلْ رَبِّ أَدْخِلْنِي مُدْخَلَ صِدْقٍ وَأَخْرِجْنِي مُخْرَجَ صِدْقٍ وَجْعَلْنِي مِنْ لَدُنْكَ سُلْطَانًا نَصِيرًا. And pray to your Lord, O my Lord, let me have an entry of truth, that is, into Medina. Now this ayah is actually, it is coming, events cast their shadows before. So Hijrah, Muhammad was going to go to Medina, he was going to make this Hijrah. But before that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching him a prayer. وَقُلْ رَبِّ أَدْخِلْنِي مُدْخَلَ صِدْقٍ. When I enter Medina, it should be an entrance of truthfulness. وَأَخْرِجْنِي مُخْرَجَ صِدْقٍ. And you take me out from this Makkah, this city of Makkah, with truth. وَجْعَلْنِي مِنْ لَدُنْكَ سُلْطَانًا نَصِيرًا. And then grant me from your special stores of authority. Grant me authority in this world which should help my mission. This was the prayer which was taught to him. And we know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he taught this prayer, actually he had accepted the prayer already. It was decided by him. that when Muhammad enters Medina, he will be entering like a king. People at Makkah were, you know, bent upon killing him. And Makkah had only 300 miles, less than 300 miles north of Makkah. The other city is Medina. Yathrib, it used to be called. And there the people are, you know, waiting for him to come, to say him the welcome. قَدْ طَلَعَ الْبَدْرُ عَلَيْنَا مِنْ سَنِّيَّاتِ الْوَدَاعِ قَدْ وَجَبَ الشُّكْرُ عَلَيْنَا مَا دَعَى لِلَّهِ دَعِي. Small girls, they were singing this song when Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was entering Medina. So what a contrast. But this happened. And Muhammad entered there as a ruler. Immediately, both the big tribes, the Aus and Khazraj, accepted him. And so he became the ruler of Medina. وَقُلْ رَبِّ أَدْخِلْ لِي مُدْخَلَ صِدْقٍ وَأَخْرِجْنِي مُخْرَجَ صِدْقٍ وَاجْعَلْ لِي مِنْ لَدُنْكَ سُلْطَانًا نَصِيرًا وَقُلْ جَاءَ الْحَقُّ وَزَهَقَ الْبَاطِلُ إِنَّ الْبَاطِلَ كَانَ زَهُوقًا. And proclaim, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, truth has come and falsehood has vanished, although it has not happened up till now, but it was sure to happen only in 8 years. What is 8 years in a nation's history? Within 8 years, Muhammad came back with 10,000 of his companions and entered Makkah victoriously. So, what would happen on that day? It is proclaimed here. Tell them, proclaim, قُلْ جَاءَ الْحَقُّ وَزَهَقَ الْبَاطِلُ. Say that truth has come and falsehood has vanished. And verily, the falsehood is ever certain to vanish. وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And we are sending down from Quran these ayat, which are remedy, healing for all the diseases of the chest and heart, haughtiness, love of wealth, love of power and authority. These are the things, these are the diseases. For that Quran is shifa. وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And a mercy for the believers. وَلَا يَزِيدُ الظَّالِمِينَ إِلَّا خَسَارًا. But it doesn't increase the evildoers. But for them, there is loss because they are not going to accept Quran. وَإِذَا أَنْعَمْنَا عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ أَعْرَضَ وَنَأَىٰ بِجَانِبِهِ. And when we bestow our blessings on a human being, then, you know, he becomes arrogant. Now he is not listening to us. He has ample to food, everything to eat, everything he has of necessity. Now why should he call us? Why should he pray to us? But when, on the other hand, وَإِذَا مَسَّهُ الشَّرِّ, when some affliction comes on him, كَانَ يَوْسَىٰ, now he becomes absolutely disappointed and totally despaired. These are the extremes of human beings. Usually the human beings, you know, they oscillate between these two extremes. قُلْ كُلُّ يَعْمَلُ عَلَىٰ شَاكِلَتِهِ. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all are working according to the personality structure that they have. What is shakila? Pattern, you know, shakila, pattern. And this pattern for every human being is fixed by two things. Hereditary factors which he has had through the genes of his parents, father, mother, grandfather, grandmother, and so forth. The genes, they give a pattern to his structure, to his personality. And number two, the environment in which he has lived. The country, the society. What's the structure of the society? What are the values? What people think? All, and what education he got? These two things combined together make a shakila of a person. His personality structure is there. Now is with this personality structure, either he turns his head towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and face, and he strives for good or for bad. The free choice remains there, but he cannot outgrow his skin. He will remain limited to the shakila. The shakila will remain with him. But he can pursue good through this shakila. And he can pursue evil also through this shakla. قُلْ كُلُّ يَعْمَلُ عَلَىٰ شَاكِلَتِهِ فَرَبُّكُمْ أَعْلَمُ بِمَنْ هُوَ أَهْدَىٰ سَبِيلًا. Your Lord knows best who is more guided to the right path. وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الرُّوحِ And they ask you, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, about the spirit. قُلِ الرُّوحُ مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي Tell them, this ruh, this spirit, human spirit, it is from the command of my Lord. وَمَا أُوتِيتُمْ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا And you have not been given from the knowledge, but very limited amount. These things you can't understand. These things belong to Alam-e-Amr. You can understand Alam-e-Khalq, this material world. You can learn, you can understand, you can use, you can discover the laws governing this physical world, material world. Then you can exploit different form of energies which are available here. But that Alam-e-Amr, you know, where there are angels, human spirits, all these things, you know, you are beyond your perception. You can't perceive, you can't conceive. وَلَئِنْ شَئْنَا لَنَذْهَبَنَّ بِالَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ ثُمَّ لَا تَجِدُ لَكَ بِهِ عَلَيْنَا وَكِيلًا O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, had we wished so, had we willed so, we could take away from you that which we have sent down to you in revelations. This Quran we have sent, and we have collected it in your chest, in your heart, in your brain. But this is our authority. If we want, we can take it back. ثُمَّ لَا تَجِدُ لَكَ بِهِ عَلَيْنَا وَكِيلًا Then you will not be able to find for you any guide against us that he can, you know, force us to give it back to you. Our authority is final. إِلَّا رَحْمَةً مِنْ رَبِّكَ But this cannot happen due to the mercy of your Lord. إِنَّ فَضْلَهُ كَانَ عَلَيْكَ كَبِيرًا Because his bounty over you is very great. And the biggest, you know, manifestation of that bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on you is this Qur'an. قُلْ لَيْنِ اِجْتَمَعَتِ الْإِنْسُ وَالْجِنُّ عَلَىٰ آيَاتُ بِمِسْلِ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ لَا آيَاتُونَ بِمِسْلِهِ Tell them, and this is the challenge, if all the human beings and all the jinns gather together and strive to compile a book like this Qur'an, they won't be able to do it. قُلْ لَيْنِ اِجْتَمَعَتِ الْإِنْسُ وَالْجِنُّ All human beings, all jinn, jinnat, they gather together on this to produce a book like Qur'an. لَا يَعْتُونَ بِمِسْلِهِ They will not be able to produce a book like this. وَلَوْ كَانَ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ زَهِيرًا Although they might be helping each other. وَلَقَدْ صَرَّفْنَا لِلنَّاسِ فِي هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ مِنْ كُلِّ مَسَلٍ The same tasreef with which we began today. And we have, in various forms, various styles, we have explained our ayat in this Qur'an. فَابَا أَكْسَرُ النَّاسِ إِلَّا كُفُورًا But most of the people, they don't accept it. They are rejecting. And only their aversion is on the increase. وَقَالُوا لَنُّ Now here comes, you know, the demands that they were making from Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Show us this miracle and then we shall believe in you that you are the Prophet of Allah. What were the demands? وَقَالُوا لَنُّ مِنَ لَكَ حَتَّى تَفْجُرَ لَنَا مِنَ الْأَرْضَ يَنْبُوعًا And they said, we are not going to believe in you, we are not going to accept you as the Messenger of Allah, unless you cause a spring to gush forth from the earth for us. In this city of Makkah, there should be a spring, you know, and it should gush from the earth, and then we can accept you as a messenger. أَوْ تَكُونَ لَكَ جَنَّةٌ مِّن نَخِيلٍ وَعِنَبٍ Or suddenly, a garden of date palms and of grapes should be there in Makkah for you. فَتُفَجَّرُ الْأَنْهَارَ خِلَالَهَا تَفْجِيرًا And in that garden, there should be rivulets and springs flowing. If you can produce it, okay, then we shall accept that you are the Messenger of Allah. أَوْ تُسْقِطُ السَّمَاءَ كَمَا زَعَمْتَ عَلَيْنَا Or you make the heaven fall on us in pieces, as you think that it will happen on the Day of Judgment, on in Qiyamah. Now, do it. وَتَاتِيَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْمَلَائِكَةِ قَبِيلًا Or you bring Allah and His angels before us, face to face. Then we shall believe, yes, you are the Messenger of Allah. أَوْ يَكُونَ لَكَ بَيْتٌ مِنْ ذُخْرُفٍ And or there should be a palace for you here in Makkah, of gold, ذُخْرُفٍ أَوْ تَرْتَعْ فِي السَّمَاءِ Or you ascend to the heaven before our own eyes. We should see that you are ascending to the heaven. وَلَنُّوْمِنَا لِرُقِيَكَ And even your ascension to the heaven, we are not going to accept. حَتَّى تُنَزِّلَ عَلَيْنَا كِتَابًا نَقْرَاهُ Unless you bring down with you over us, on us a book which we can read ourselves. قُلْ In reply to all these demands, what was the reply from Allah? قُلْ Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Subhana Rabbi. Glorified is my Lord. He can do anything. But when have I claimed that I am God, I can do this? My claim is that I am a human being. Hal kuntu illa basharan rasoola. My claim, you should demand proof from me according to the claim that I am presenting before you. I never claimed that I am God. I never claimed that I have all this authority. I never claim that this whole universe is under me, no, nothing of the sort. I am a human being like you. Only the thing is that Allah has chosen me and He has sent revelation to me and He has appointed me a messenger to you. وَمَا مَنَعَ النَّاسَ أَن يُؤْمِنُوا إِذْ جَاءَهُمُ الْهُدَى And there is nothing which has prevented these people to believe when this guidance has come to them. إِلَّا أَن قَالُوا أَبْعَثَ اللَّهُ بَشَرًا رَسُولًا Except this thing that they say, Has Allah sent a man, a human, a mortal, as a messenger? If Allah wanted to send, He could send an angel. How come? A mortal, human being. And He has been sent as a messenger. قُلْ لَوْ كَانَ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَلَائِكَةٌ يَمْشُونَ مُطْمَئِنِّينَ لَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْهِ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَلَكًا رَسُولًا Say to them, if there had been angels walking on this earth, with contentment, then we would have sent an angel for them as a messenger. We have sent Muhammad as messenger to you. You are human beings. For you there should be a human person, a human being. But had there been angels here, we would have sent an angel. So actually, it is the reply, قُلْ لَوْ كَانَ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَلَائِكَةٌ يَمْشُونَ مُطْمَئِنِّينَ لَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْهِ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَلَكًا رَسُولًا قُلْ كَفَى بِاللَّهِ شَهِيدًا بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَكُمْ Say, Allah is sufficient as a witness between you and me. إِنَّهُ كَانَ بِعِبَادِهِ خَبِيرًا بَصِيرًا Verily, He about His bondsmen, He is aware of everything and He is seeing everything. وَمَنْ يَهْدِ اللَّهُ فَهُوَ الْمُهْتَدِ Whomsoever Allah guides to the right path, well, He is the guided one. وَمَنْ يُغْلِلْ And whom Allah sends astray, فَلَنْ تَجَدَ لَهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءَ مِنْ دُونِهِ For them you will not find any helpers except Allah. They can't now bring them to the right path. وَنَحْشُرُهُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ عَلَىٰ وَجُوهِهِمْ And we shall gather them on the day of the judgment, prone on their faces. أُمْيًا وَبُكْمًا وَسُمَّ They will be blind and dumb and deaf. مَاوَاهُمْ جَهَنَّمْ Their abode will be Jahannam. كُلَّمَا خَبَتْ زِدْنَاهُمْ سَعِيرًا When the fire of the hell Whenever it will abate, we shall increase it in the flame and severity. ذَلِكَ جَزَاهُمْ جَهَنَّمْ جَزَاهُمْ بِأَنَّهُمْ كَفَرُوا And this is the reward for them because they did kufr. They rejected the call of Muhammad. كَفَرُوا بِآيَاتِنَا They rejected our ayat. وَقَالُوا وَإِذَا كُنَّا عِظَامًا وَرُفَاتًا And they said the same thing repeatedly. When we become bones and pieces, أَيْنَّا لَمَبْعُثُونَ خَلْقًا جَدِيدًا Are we going to be created again in a new creation? أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا Don't they see? أَنَّ اللَّهَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ قَادِرٌ عَلَىٰ يَخْلُقَ مِثْلَهُمْ That Allah, who has created all the heavens and the earth, He is not able to create the like of them. He created you. Can't He create you again? How come? What's the reason? وَجَعَلَ لَهُمْ أَجَلًا لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ And Allah has fixed for them a time, ajal, a fixed time. لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ There's no doubt about that. فَأَبَ الظَّالِمُونَ إِلَّا كَفُورًا But these evil doers, they refuse except ungratefulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ لَوْ أَنْتُمْ تَمْلِكُونَ خَزَائِنَ رَحْمَةِ رَبِّي إِذَا لَمْ سَكْتُمْ خَشْيَةَ الْإِنْفَاقِ وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ قَتُورًا Tell them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O people, had you possessed the treasures of mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You would have certainly withheld all the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fearing expending. Maybe it is finished. Because ta'ala insanu qatura. Insan is, human beings are miserly. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has spread his mercy to all the creatures, and he is not fearing that his store of mercy will come to an end. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.